sexier than most and taller than even more. I'm enjoying life, and if you enjoy laughing, adventures, and the outdoors, then hi. Although there was some initial hesitation, as can be expected on Tinder, when Pete asked Lorraine out to a nice dinner for their first date, she agreed, stating, Pete was proving to be an old-fashioned gentleman in a sea of casual swipers. Today is a celebration of commitment, of friendship, of family, and of two people declaring their love for one another. On behalf of Pete and Lorraine, I welcome you and thank you all for gathering here on this beautiful day to witness their marriage ceremony.
It was a bitter cold night. Lorraine and I met in New Rochelle for dinner, as we often do. But this night was different. It was magical almost. Lorraine had actually forgotten we had dinner plans, which is very unlike her. And when we got to our usual restaurant, it turned out to be closed. So we ended up at a very random, quirky Italian joint with old-timey booths and weird knickknacks. We sat in our booth, and Lorraine was almost shaking with good news. We split a bottle of wine and a plate of spaghetti, and over the next couple hours, my beautiful friend told me all about this new guy she'd started seeing. She told me all about Pete. And I've never seen Lorraine with a lighter heart or a brighter sparkle.
We've known each other for over a quarter of a century, man. Like, that's a long time. And no matter the distance, no matter the time apart, our friendship, it's always grown, but it's never changed. And I'm so appreciative and thankful for that, man. Like, I love you like a brother, and I hope you always know that.
It's very rare in life that you find someone who really gets you. Lorraine and I get each other. But most importantly, the love we have for each other is undeniable, unconditional, and it's more than just a friendship. Because Lorraine, you're my sister.
Lorraine told me that cold winter night over dinner, almost in disbelief about this guy, how he would care for her, like really care for her, comfort and nurture her after long hellish days at work, lovingly, selflessly caress her while she fell asleep.
Darling Lorraine, your parents must be so proud to have such a beautiful, hardworking, caring, and dare I say hilarious, new son-in-law to welcome into the family. That joke only works if those same things apply to you too. And it's really true. And when we first got to know each other, you had no reason to love me the way you did, except for the fact that I was Pete's friend. And I grew to realize that anything that was important to Pete was important to you.
Pete, thank you for being such an amazing man and for treating Lorraine the way you do. I think I can speak for all of our friends and family when I say we adore you and think the world of you.
That night in New Rochelle, I asked Lorraine if I could text Pete. I'm coming to the end, I promise. I texted some weird hearts and I just wrote my name. And he was confused and he wrote, Lorraine, your friends are a terrible judge of character. And I wrote back and I'm like, Pete, it's Dara. And I wrote like a purple heart. And he said, oh, hi, how are you? And I wrote, I've never been better. My best friend in the world found you.
I knew he was perfect for Lorraine. Before even meeting him. When she told me how much she was falling in love, I knew this was serious. I said, Lorraine, just tell me, what is he like? She smiled and replied, he reminds me of you. He's like you, Dad.
I didn't do it. I didn't step on your bill. What do I mean?
Oh my God.
Did I get some of your makeup on my forehead?
Oh.
God, you look gorgeous.
I promise I didn't step on your bill. Good job.
No, socks are good so, too.
They do. Oh my God, I'm so nervous. I
don't think Jackie will mind.
I don't think it's Jackie's
funny. I know.
I love you.
I love you, baby.
I could not be more proud and honored to choose you as my husband today. You are a true gentleman in every sense of the word. You are strong, yet gentle. You are confident, yet humble. And you give so generously your time and your love to everyone. You have dedicated your life to servicing others. You give so often and so eagerly, with never asking for anything in return. I love you not only for all of these things, but for who I am when I'm with you. You make my soul shine brighter than it ever has. And no matter how tough the day is or how anxious I get, you're always there to listen without judgment. You put your arms around me, you kiss me gently, and you whisper, "Everything's gonna be all right." So I promise to always comfort you in return, to appreciate all the little things you do for me, which are so many, and to never stop complimenting you. I promise to occasionally let you win at Rummy Cube, and to sometimes let you think you love me more. I promise to cherish every night I get to fall asleep in your arms, and every morning I get to wake up to your kisses. I promise, Pete Purcell, to love you fiercely, in all forms, now and forever.
Lorraine, today I am overwhelmed with pride. Yes, love is in the air, but pride is the thing I feel the most. Mostly, I'm proud that on this day, it's your eyes I get to look into. Proud that I get to spend my life giving you chances to make me look good again. Proud to simply say, I'm marrying you. I ask you to marry me not because I want to spend the rest of my days with you, but mainly because I can't imagine spending another day without you. Every morning that I wake up next to you, I find myself falling more in love, and I promise that that will never change. I promise that when we're old and gray, or bald, I will always see you as the woman who stands before me, vibrant, beautiful, and full of life. I promise that when life has your glass half empty, it will forever be my mission to make it feel full. I promise to make you smile when all you want to do is be blue, because baby, blue ain't your color. I promise that I'll always let you take 2 bites of my food, even though you only asked for one. And lastly, I promise that I will never take your love for granted. I will never stop fighting for the opportunity to prove that I love you more.
It It gives me all the confidence in the world to know that all you need is Lorraine's hand in your hand to be a happy man. So everyone, please raise your glass and do a little cheers. I love you guys.
Both very much. I wish you years of happiness. Pete and Lorraine.
Their love will come to you, hoping just because I spoke the words that they're true. As if I offered up a crystal ball to look through, where there was one, now forever and ever, there will be two. I love you.
It is my joy and privilege to now pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss.